Assalamu alaikum, 6 p.m. This is Radio Pakistan. The news read by Farzana Khan. First, the headlines. Senate was informed today that Pakistan is pursuing a zero-tolerance policy in war against terrorism. AJK Prime Minister says India's aggressive designs are a major threat to peace in South Asia. World Human Rights Watchdog Amnesty International has expressed serious concern over use of pellet guns by Indian troops on protesters in occupied Kashmir. Secretary of State says Washington recognizes Turkey's legitimate right to secure its borders. Australia beat New Zealand by 5 wickets in a match of 2020 Tri-Series at Auckland today. And now the news in detail. The Senate was informed today that law will take its course in the case of former spokesperson of Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan, Ehsanullah Ehsan, who surrendered himself before an intelligence agency last year. Minister of State for Interior Talal Chaudhry assured the House during question hour that Ehsanullah Ehsan, involved in various terrorist incidents, will not be pardoned. He said video statements of Ehsanullah Ehsan have also been made public, which are sufficient to reflect that the concerned departments are dealing his case as per the law of the land. The Minister of State said Pakistan has adopted a zero-tolerance policy in the war against terrorism. Responding to a question, Minister for States and Frontier Regions Abdul Qadir Baloch told the House that over 331 million rupees have been dispersed as compensation to the victims of terrorist incidents in the tribal areas. Abdul Qadir Baloch said 100 billion rupees will be spent every year for a period of 10 years for the development of Fatah on fast-track basis. Later, the House was adjourned to meet again on Monday evening. The National Assembly was informed today that National Culture Policy will be announced on the 25th of this month. Minister of State for Information and Broadcasting, Mariam Aurangzeb, told the House during question hour that the policy envisages measures to revive endangered and extinct cultures. She said this policy includes education on cultural diversity and necessary awareness campaigns. She said the policy has been framed after getting inputs from the provincial governments. Minister of State for Maritime Affairs Jafar Iqbal told the House that 30 railway stations are being upgraded at an estimated cost of 2,972.95 million rupees. Parliamentary Secretary for Cabinet Division Raja Javed Ikhlas told the House that two nuclear power plants of 2,400 megawatt are near completion. The House has now been adjourned to meet again on Monday at 5 p.m. President Mamnoon Hussein says people with less resources in Pakistan are enjoying good health facilities due to prudent policies of the government. He was talking to a delegation of Royal College of Physicians, Edinburgh, led by Professor Derek Bell, who called on the president in Islamabad today. The president said the government has taken several steps to provide cost-effective healthcare facilities to the people, and Punjab government's measures have produced better results in this regard. Professor Derek Bell told the president that his institution is considering proposals to provide training to young doctors in Pakistan. Pakistan's ambassador to France, Muinul Haq, says bilateral trade is an upward trajectory. He was talking to representatives of a cross-section of Pakistani community and the Pakistani media in Paris. He said French companies are taking interest to invest in Pakistan and benefit from special economic zones which are being set up in Pakistan as part of the CPEC. He said Pakistani diaspora is an asset for the country. A two-member bench of the Supreme Court, headed by Chief Justice Saqib Nassar, has adjourned hearing of Naqibullah murder case for a fortnight. The court cancelled protective bail of former SSP Rao Anwar and directed all security agencies to apprehend Rao Anwar. Pakistan Post and National Bank of Pakistan signed a memorandum of understanding in Islamabad today to boost digital financial services in the country through a huge network of 12,000 post offices countrywide. Under the agreement, National Bank of Pakistan will install ATMs at major post offices across the country for quick transfer of home remittances, international remittances, and further improvement of disbursement of pension. The MOU is also aimed at achieving the target of the State Bank of Pakistan for strengthening national financial inclusion strategy by extending digital financial services to 50% population of the country by 2020. This is Radio Pakistan giving you the news. Azad Kashmir Prime Minister Raja Farooq Haider Khan and President Sardar Mohammad Masood Khan have appealed to the international community and the UN to take a serious notice of Indian ceasefire line violations at line of control. Addressing a press conference in Islamabad today, Prime Minister AJK and Indian troops are particularly targeting school children, hospital vans, and women and aged people at LOC. He said Indian aggressive designs are a major threat to peace in South Asia. He urged the world powers to pay attention to core issue of Kashmir and resolve it in line with the UN resolutions. The World Human Rights Watchdog, Amnesty International, has expressed serious concern over the use of pellet guns by Indian troops on protesters in occupied Kashmir. According to Kashmir Media Service, the Amnesty has written a letter to the Canadian Prime Minister, Justin Trudeau, ahead of his visit to India, urging him to raise the matter of the use of pellet guns in his meeting with the Indian Prime Minister, scheduled for next week. Meanwhile, in occupied Kashmir, Indian troops in their fresh act of state terrorism martyred two Kashmiri youth during a violent military operation in Balakot area of Poonch district. U.S. Secretary of State Rex Tillerson says the United States recognizes Turkey's legitimate right to secure its borders. At a joint news conference with Turkish Foreign Minister Mevlut Cavusoglu in Ankara today, Tillerson at the same time called on Ankara to show restraint in its operation in Syria's Afrin region and avoid actions that would escalate tension. Turkey's Foreign Minister Mevlut Cavusoglu, after the talk, said that both the countries have agreed to set up mechanisms to settle a series of disputes between the two countries. Iran's President Hassan Rouhani has strongly criticized the Trump administration's recognition of Jerusalem as Israel's capital and urged Muslims to support the Palestinian cause. He was addressing a congregation after Friday prayers at Mecca Masjid in the southern Indian city of Hyderabad during his three-day visit to India. He called for unity among the Muslims. Hassan Rouhani also lashed out at the United States for imposing a ban on travelers from six largely Muslim countries. Myanmar's Home Minister Kwai Swe said this his country is ready to take back Rohingya Muslims who fled during the violence. He told Bangladesh President Abdul Hamid in Dhaka today that Myanmar is ready under a deal signed by the two countries last year. He said that Myanmar will implement the recommendations by a commission led by the former UN Secretary General Kofi Annan regarding Rohingya Muslims. Qatar's Red Crescent Society will implement humanitarian projects worth $2 million in Iraq this year. The society announced in a statement in Doha that these projects would be funneled through coordination with stakeholders to mobilize community support on the level of institutions and individuals. And now cricket. Australia beat New Zealand by 5 wickets in a match of 2020 tri-series at Auckland today. Batting first, New Zealand set a victory target of 243 for 6 wickets in allotted 20 overs. In reply, Australia achieved the highest run chase in the international 2020 cricket history as they reached 245 by 5 wickets with 7 balls left. And finally, the weather report. Mainly cold and dry weather is expected in most parts of the country during the next 12 hours. However, light rain with light snowfall over the hills is expected at a few places in Gilgit-Baltistan. To end the news, here again are some of the headlines. Informed today that Pakistan is pursuing a zero-tolerance policy in war against terrorism. AGK Prime Minister says India's aggressive designs are a major threat to peace in South Asia. World Human Rights Watchdog Amnesty International has expressed serious concern over the use of pellet guns by Indian troops on protesters in occupied Kashmir. U.S. Secretary of State says Washington recognizes Turkey's legitimate right to secure its borders. Australia beat New Zealand by 5 wickets in a match of 2020 Tri-Series at Auckland today. And that is the end of the news. For more news and analyses, log on to our website radio.gov.pk and also watch live video streaming of our bulletins on the link facebook.com/radiopakistannewsofficial.